How we doing, guys? Cuban Bully TV here. Make sure you guys like and subscribe. Today we're gonna be dropping one of the parts of Dave Wilson and Carlos Cedillo's video. It was four parts, so we're gonna drop part one today. We hope you guys like it. And for those of you at home that don't speak English, ¿cómo estamos, amigo? Hoy vamos a tener la primera parte de la entrevista de Dave Wilson con el señor Carlos. Eran cuatro partes del video, pero hoy vamos a poner la parte una para todos los que quieran ver el video. Esté seguro que se suscriban a la página y le den like. Y bueno, como pueden ver, vamos a seguir trabajando. Eso nos vemos. Cuban Bully TV, go subscribe. How we doing, guys? We are all the way in Fredericksburg, Virginia. I'm here with Mr. Dave Wilson himself. How you doing, sir?
All right, how's it going?
Doing all right?
All right.
And Mr. Carlos Caicedo. Caicedos?
Caicedo.
Caicedo. And we're here, guys. We just want to go over a few things and kind of touch on the direction of where the American Bully's going. And my man Carlos here would have has a couple of questions as well. We're going to kind of have an interview and immediate everything. So without further ado, Mr. Carlos.
Can I say something real quick?
Yes, sir.
Just so everybody know, there's a lot of questions around the world of the direction of the American Bully, where we started, where we're going. A lot of questions about the differences of the varieties and things like that. So Carlos has got quite a few questions from association that he's affiliated with, a World Breed Association, that they have about the direction. So we can answer those questions today with Carlos and get a little in-depth into the direction of the American Bully breed. So
sounds great. ¿Cómo estamos, okay, señor?
Bien.
Mucho
gracias.
Gusto.
Hey, Dave. Bueno, la primera pregunta. ¿Existen diferentes percepciones acerca de la actualidad del American Bully? So, ¿hay algún tipo de valoración oficial por parte del registro que pudiese dar un parte o una idea acerca de la actualidad del American Bully?
Did you get the question, or would you like me to
repeat? Probably better to explain it
okay.
That way to people.
So, what he was asking, guys, he wants to know the variety of the American Bullies with the differences that there is. ¿Cuál fue la segunda parte? Perdón.
¿Existe algún tipo de valoración oficial?
He wants to know if there's an official evaluation and like what are they basing it off of, because what he was saying with the extreme and stuff like that. So he wants to know where does it stand as far as right now.
As far as the...
Si existe, tú, si tú puedes dar de manera oficial... La actualidad de la raza.
Can you give your official your
oficialmente cómo está la raza?
Can you give your official opinion on where the American Bully is?
Yeah.
So that's
yeah.
a better way of putting
okay.
it. Okay. So we're gonna. He wants to know, guys, what is the official or what is Dave's official opinion on where the American Bully stands as of now?
We've been around now since 2004, so it's been a growing process. It was a breed that started with a variation of lineages. And over the past 15 years now, we've been developing the standard to give a unified look of what the breed and its varieties should be. And it's been a growing process. So where we are today, we are not at a completed process of the final form of what the breed should be. We are finally starting to see the uniformity of the breed. We're starting to really understand the differences between the varieties. We're starting to really understand the look of the breed type and the breed varieties. We're not at a level where we're completely there yet. And if you go to shows and you're a witness to the events, you still see a bit of diversity among the looks of the breed. So we as a whole, as a breed, we are not there yet. We have come a long way over the past 14 years, 15 years, but we're still not at the final goal. That's why we're still seeing differences in the looks of dogs. That's why we're not seeing a complete uniformity of all the dogs looking as their variety standard should be. So it's not a completed process.
Correct.
And it's definitely something that has grown, and it's definitely something that we're starting to see, once again, more uniformity, but I say we're still few generations and years away from having that unified look. And what we're doing as ABKC, we're investing more now into the training and getting clarity of what these varieties should have, you know, the looks, everything to the standard. So over the past year, we've actually started developed. We've been working with different artists to draw sketches of each variety and explain everything in detail from the standard of what every terminology means to what it should actually look like. Okay. So we're in a process right now of having an artist sketch those out so that people can actually get a visual of when they're reading the standard and they're reading a trade in the standard, what that actually should look like.
Okay.
And that's the stage we're in now, and we're working on that process. And as we're doing that, we're going back and training our judges and working with our judges. And these are things that we'll be introducing to the community more via the website, via other promotional material that we'll be doing for the breed. So I think where we are with the breed today, we are definitely advanced from where we started, but we're far from the completion because we still have a lot of differences amongst the breeders and the dogs that are being displayed.
Okay.
Okay. Good. Thank you.
¿Quiere que te lo traduzca?
Sí, podría ser.
So, a brief... en otras palabras, en pocas palabras, él dice que él está muy conforme con dónde está, cómo ha movido el American Bully para adelante, pero que todavía estamos en los tiempos muy jóvenes de determinar que si los vamos a mover más para adelante o no, porque él lo que está diciendo es que hay diferentes variedades de American Bullies, pero que desde donde empezamos a donde estamos ahora se está moviendo en la dirección correcta, pero todavía no hemos llegado al producto final que el American Bully quiere estar y donde ellos quieren estar como una registración.
O sea, oficialmente reconocemos que aún estamos en proceso.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Esta pregunta tiene que ver con la anterior, okay. Y es, ¿cuál es el futuro de las variedades del American Bully?
So, he wants to know what is
the future of the varieties.
Of the varieties.
I've explained this before, and a good example would be to look at the model of the Schnauzer, for example.
Okay.
The Schnauzer started very similar to how we were, where it was separated by varieties, and then over time, the varieties became individual breeds. It's a very long process to do that. So where we started was having the division of the varieties. The three varieties have the same standard, but they're divided by height. The XL being at the higher end, the pocket being at the lower end. Mm-hmm. It's just a division of height. What you have to do in time is separate that even more. Mm-hmm. You have to have more separation of the heights in order to have more individual looks for each variety.
Okay.
It's a long process. It's not a process that happens in 1 year. It's not a process that happens in 10 years. You have to take steps to get to that level.
Mm-hmm.
At the current moment, the XLs are starting to separate themselves, and XLs are breeding to XLs. Mm-hmm. Breeders are breeding XLs to XLs. Still within the standard in the pocket, you have people mixed breeding the standards and pockets, and it's still basically all within the same. You're getting some that are standard, some that are pocket. You're getting some people that are breeding more for pocket. But over time, what we have to do is add division, not just division, but we have to add more separation to the sizes. And once you do that, you will also have to accommodate certain things because a dog, once it gets to a certain height, is going to be different on its movement versus a pocket. It's going to have a... So once you've done the separation, then you're going to have to adjust some of the other things that accommodate the separation.
Okay.
Again, movement would be one, and there'll be some other things that will have to be basically tweaked in order to fit that. But it's a long process.
Okay.
And the first stage of the process is identifying varieties. The very first stage. So that's where we want to be for 2020. We want to be able to identify the varieties and have that printed on the pedigrees. So you could take a dog at a year of age to a judge that's trained to identify variety to evaluate the dog, whether it's properly measuring the dog or evaluating whether it's classic or standard. And once you have that evaluation completed and the judge has signed off on it, then that will be documented on the pedigrees. So your dog will be a pocket or an XL. Still the same breed, but that's the first step you take is identifying the differences in the varieties.
Okay.
Later on, you will do by changing the standard and adding a separation of height and go further and further to eventually, in the way off future, where those dogs are only bred to dogs once they've been evaluated as being a pocket.
Yeah.
You would only breed pocket to pocket.
Mm-hmm.
That's the steps you take to eventually separating
to
them.
Separate
as a breed. But this is way in the future.
Yeah.
Where we're talking today, the first step is identifying the differences of the varieties. Which we're working on that program now so that we hope to have it in 2020 where we will have certain judges that are able to evaluate, identify that, and that will at least be printed on the pedigree, so you have confirmation that this is a pocket, or okay, this is an XL, or this is that. So that's the first step where
okay
we are today.
Okay.
Entendí. Sí.
En base a eso me gustaría decir lo siguiente. Hace poco se publicó desde aquí, desde la oficina, que se abriría una nueva categoría para Excel de 9 a 12 meses. La comunidad puede esperar que suceda lo mismo con las demás variedades en un tiempo muy corto, o también es algo que va a suceder muy lejos.
Okay, so he wants to know, with the XLs trying to separate themselves and be in their own variety, and have like their own 9 to 12 and 1 to 2, is that something that the other varieties are going to also try to determine? And how far do you think we are from something like that taking place?
Okay, first to answer the question, yes, we are trying to do that with all the varieties.
Okay,
and in the long run, you'll be able to do that from birth because okay they'll be identified that
okay
way. As of this moment, because there's only a division between, there's no separation, it's just division of height, it's very difficult to identify that at a young age. We spent 2 years evaluating and watching the XLs to see from 6 to 9, do the XLs reach the height,
required
that they're considered an XL? What we found is in 6 to 9, most of them do, but some still do not.
Okay.
So that's a little bit difficult still. But what we found from 9 to 12, all of the XLs had reached the height that labeled them an XL. So we made the decision that we can separate the XL from 9 to 12, comfortably separate that at that age, knowing that these dogs have already reached the limit to where they're considered XL, and now deserve that. The pockets is this year. We're also looking at the pockets. We're going to be evaluating pocket for the next year to see if the dogs that we feel from 9 to 12 are maxing out and they're not passing the limit to where they would be considered a standard.
Okay.
So that's the next step.
Okay.
It's going to be very difficult to do that from 3 to 6 and possibly 6 to 9, because a lot of these dogs haven't matured quite at that level. And until we start to do changes to where we're adding more separation, that's when we'll be able to better identify them at a younger age.
Okay.
Ideally, you want to identify them from birth. And the only way you're going to do that is when we've created
variety
a system to where these are all separated,
exactly,
you know, not considered the same. So, yes.
Okay. So, para la gente que está mirando, es lo que quiere decirle. So, el Excel, el XL, ya tiene, ellos estuvieron estudiando casi como para 2 años, que el XL de 6 a 9 era muy difícil todavía para determinar si por la altura iban a ser XL o no. So, ellos estudiaron más y vieron que de 9 a 12 es cuando ven que el Excel llega a un punto ya de altura que son Excel. So, para las otras variedades, ellos están tratando de hacer lo mismo, y en este momento lo están haciendo con los paquetes, a ver a qué edad más o menos pueden
estar seguros
de que van a hacer si paquete o extender, porque cuando ya nacen, entonces es más fácil ir y mirar que son paquetes a qué cierta edad, porque en este momento los Excel son los únicos que ellos han visto, que de 9 a 12 están separando. So,
quiere decir, lo siento, porque puede explicar mucho en español, pero faltan muchas palabras técnicas. Por eso quiere decir
pero
en inglés.
Tienes toda la razón.
Pero aquí estamos nosotros.
De hecho, y eso se sale de las preguntas que yo tenía preparadas, pero me interesa, por ejemplo, esta. Aclarando que el futuro de las variedades es terminar en unas razas a un tiempo muy largo, ¿podría un criador desde ya definir su objetivo, decir: yo voy a crear el packet y quiero presentar, si abren la posibilidad, mis cachorros en packet, o sea, tratar de ir especializando su propia cría sin necesidad de que la división exista al interior del estándar como algo obligatorio, o sea, como una separación oficial?
O sea, como ir separándose sin tenerla físicamente en...
Que la propia comunidad dé el salto.
So he's saying that without it being established yet, like how you guys have done the you know, research for the XLs, you know, being that they're at 9 to 12 and they changed, he's saying that, is that something that the community can start doing already to start helping move forward with the establishment of, you know, being that these are pockets, this is a standard, by breeding for that and
yes,
sticking to what you want to breed to.
For example,
doing the dividing it in a way that it's not set in stone yet, but start moving
correct,
toward
right
that.
Well, That is what the XL breeders have done.
Okay.
The XL breeders have isolated themselves to where they're breeding XLs to XLs.
To XLs.
So they're having consistent generations of only XLs because they've made a decision they want to be an XL breeder.
Okay.
So they're working on projects that are separating themselves. So they've already done the steps. The first step has to be the breeders.
Yes.
Because we can set things in stone, but until breeders start doing these things, nothing will change.
Okay.
So the XL, you have to have breeders. You have to have breeders that say, you know, I want to be a breeder, and for my line, I want pockets. Mm-hmm. So that particular breeder would take the stages and the steps to start breeding the dogs to where they're only producing dogs of that variety. Mm-hmm. And that's the first step, so that you have a breeder with a consistency of dogs that fits that variety. The XL breeders are doing that already. Mm-hmm. There's still a lot of confusion within Classic, Standard, and Pocket amongst breeders where they aren't breeding for the clarity of that. Mm-hmm. So breeders need to, they have to mm-hmm. breed for clarity.
Okay.
If I'm a breeder, I want to have a consistent look of something. So when people look into my program, they say, this is what that program is. Consistency is the key of a good breeder. So the breeders need to start doing that. What we're going to start doing is at a year old, the evaluation to help identify that.
Yes.
But the breeders have to take the initiative and the stages in order to breed for whatever their program is.
Okay. So él dice que es muy responsable, la responsabilidad es de los creadores, porque si ellos se ponen de acuerdo a que si yo voy a estar en un programa que produce solamente pockets, que eso es lo que ellos tienen que empezar a empujar, porque lo que ellos van a hacer al año, ellos lo que van a hacer es ayudarte identificar cuál es el que es el pocket, que
los parámetros
son los parámetros, exacto. Eso es lo que está diciendo, es que es exclusivamente la responsabilidad de la comunidad de decir, ok, yo voy a dedicarme a solamente los pockets o solamente los... Porque en estos momentos hay gente que están criando pockets con estándar y Excels con pockets y cosas así. So, si la comunidad se pone de acuerdo y estuviera creando los pockets con los pockets, es más fácil para ellos cuando ellos vengan a aplicar eso al año que lo van a hacer.